Oh, well, hey there. And greetings, Earthlings. How the hell is everybody? Sorry, I haven't done a video in a few days. Been a little busy. Hit some theme parks, did some fun stuff. Check out my Instagram and TikTok if you have not seen that. It was pretty fun. I did a few, you know, reviews on a couple of rides and stuff, so that was cool. But I came back to some exciting news. Yet again, we're hearing more and more as DCEU continues to build out their portfolio, finally. But it looks like Dwayne The Rock Johnson is a big part of this, because a report came out a few days ago when I was out from We Got This Covered, saying that Dwayne Johnson reportedly wants some Black Adam cameos across the DCEU. Naturally, we can imagine this is going to be what? Most likely, it's probably going to be maybe a little Shazam and the new one that I think they just wrapped filming on that. Of course, the Black Adam coming out. There's also another article here. I'll try to link it in the description if I can find it. But I remember reading something over the weekend that said there's been this battle between Warner and HBO Max for the Snyderverse. I don't know if that's rumor, but that's kind of the speculation, as there's a couple properties that they want to continue. That's because obviously Warner Media talked about having a canon, and Snyderverse didn't fall into that. But it now looks like, with everything that's going on with like Batgirl, we talked about that, and it looks like it might even have J.K. Simmons in it as Commissioner Gordon, potentially. The HBO Max Black Canary spinoff that just got announced. So I think it talks about this. Let's kind of get into this article here real quick. It starts off by saying, looking at the upcoming DCEU projects, it's hard to try and get reading on how it all fits together. J.K. Simmons entering talks to return as Commissioner Gordon and Batgirl, okay, called it, would indicate that it occupies the same narrative as The Flash, given that the latter features the Snyderverse. Ezra Miller and Ben Affleck, both whom interacted with Simmons. Yeah, so that's kind of the confusing part they're talking about, is if you do something with Batgirl and you include J.K. Simmons, then us as the viewer are like, well, okay, so Batgirl lives in the Snyderverse, right? Because J.K. Simmons was only in the Snyderverse. HBO Max Black Canary spinoff, which I think could be kind of dope, will obviously be connected to Birds of Prey, which itself was an offshoot from David Ayer's Suicide Squad. But James Gunn's recent R-rated romp wasn't tied to any of the titles, which I did a review on that. Awesome flick. I recommend James Gunn's The Suicide Squad. It's a canonical nightmare, if I'm saying that right. But we can at least be safe in the knowledge that Dwayne Johnson's Black Adam will exist in the same pocket of the universe as the Shazam franchise, which obviously has nothing to do with the Snyderverse. But for one thing, the actor and producer Seven Bucks Banner are involved with both properties behind the camera. Zachary Levy has barely been able to contain his excitement. Possibility of throwing down with The Rock. I agree. I think that's going to be a cool fight. We're now hearing from sources, the same ones that told us Ben Affleck will be returning as the Batman and the Flash, long before it was even confirmed, that Johnson is keen to ensure that the Dirty Harry of superheroes makes his presence felt across the DCU, not just in Black Adam or Shazam. Ooh. Of course, a lot of that depends on the Black Adam, yada, yada, yada. Yeah, so that's kind of the funky thing, right? Is how does this look to the universe? Because, you know, The Rock obviously is going to make a staple, but if you follow Black Adam, you know, he's prevalent in the Justice League. He battles Superman and the Justice League. So what are you going to do? You're going to reboot the Justice League within the next couple of years and then have Black Adam fight those guys? I mean, I don't know. I mean, if you're not going to do Ben Affleck and Henry Cavill, I mean, what characters? Because they got to be older. You know, I mean, The Rock's like 60. You can't have him, a 60-year-old, going up against, you know, Robert Pattinson, right, in that universe. So, I don't know. Again, this has always been DC's problem, but it's so easy. I just don't understand. We've been following the Snyderverse for a while, and everything that's been going on with Suicide Squad, it looks like DCU is maybe trying to get shit together and doing a couple of these spinoffs, but I'm game for whatever. You can do a Snyderverse and easily have The Rock with Black Adam going up against Henry Cavill and Ben Affleck's Batman and do the Snyderverse, but then also have Robert Pattinson, you know, and also have Michael B. Jordan and his Superman. Like, it's okay to have multiple universes. Don't get hooked on this thing of like, I got to have like the same crazy cinematic universe that Marvel does, because you fucked that up years ago, DC. This is your best shot. You got it here. Don't mess it up this time. Peace. See you soon.